Well, she's... Oh, we know who she is. She's Katherine Jenkins. She's a fabulous singer and a very naughty girl.
Oh, do you want to explain? What's the naughty bit?
What a nice introduction. Thank you.
We used to have dinner quite a lot in LA in our Hollywood years. And I'll tell you, she's...
Well, things have changed.
She's a good mum,
Morgan.
By that old girl.
Since you've become a mother of two,
yes.
This is your first interview since...
Yes.
A live television interview since your little one was born, who is now...
4.5 months. Mm. Yes, and very, very cute.
Do you feel... Is it pressure to go back to work, or do you feel like this is... It's sometimes a relief, frankly, for mums to go back to work when you've been looking after kids. How do you feel about it at the moment?
You know, I've loved being in the baby bubble and sort of having that bonding time and being with my family. And that's, of course, like a such a special time. It's also really lovely to be able to come back and to be able to perform. But he's really portable, so I've been able to take him into the studio and
love
like, share that with
baby.
Him. I know, it's been amazing.
Does he
actually.
Cry a lot when you sing? Or?
He doesn't cry. My first one used to cry all the time. As soon as I used to warm up, it was like the worst sound ever. Right?
No, I read an interview with you in the Event magazine, I met on Sunday yesterday. Yeah. I was very emotional.
Mm.
You got very emotional thinking about whether you could even continue working now you have these two little ones.
Yeah.
And then also emotional about whether you could continue going to see the troops in far-flung war zones like Afghanistan, which you've always done.
Yeah.
Because, again, you'd be leaving your little ones behind. It's a very risky trip. But I was surprised to see you basically crying quite a lot in that interview.
It's the hormones. I'm just a big, big blubbering mess at the moment.
Has it been getting to you a bit, this real new challenge for you as to whether you can be both?
I think it's like, you know, any working mum. You're trying your best to keep all the plates up in the air and you feel like you're probably not doing anything very well. And I think there's that sort of thing of I want to be the best mum that I can, but I also want to show my children that I'm passionate about something and mummy works hard at something. So there is that to contend with. In respect of the going out to the forces, it's something I feel so passionately about and I never want to stop doing that.
Well, the forces, sweetheart.
So I feel like it's something that I want them to be proud of that mummy goes to do. So I think it just is going to take a bit more discussion, but I don't really see myself stopping that, to be honest. I think it's something that I hope that they will understand why I wanted to go and do it so much.
So you haven't decided against doing it?
No, very just, much.
But still weighing up, because, you know, there's more at stake now, isn't there?
There's one trip that I'm going to be doing this autumn, which is an international trip, but not to actually one of the war zones, but going to sing to the troops. So that's definitely something I'll continue
Because you
to
are
do.
The new Vera Lynn, aren't you?
Well, Vera Lynn for me is, you know, is such an icon and such an inspiration that I'm to be mentioned in the same sentence as her. It's just I love being involved with the troops. That's just very special.
Now we've got a clip of your new video.
Yes.
You're a mezzo soprano, aren't you?
Yeah, mezzo.
No one has any idea what that actually is, but it sounds great. It's quite a kind of like a it's a forceful voice, isn't it?
Well,
it's not like a little squeaky soprano. It's like a proper. You know? How did you wake up one day and you just sang like that?
Well, you're given it, aren't you? It's sort of, I didn't choose to be a mezzo-soprano. It's the voice that you're given.
I got a messy soprano. It's a bit different. What did you get? You can sing, actually, can't you?
I've got earache. That's what I've got. You're emotional in that video. You mentioned you're in a kind of emotional bubble at the moment. But what's the song about that makes you
Well, the song is about saying goodbye to somebody, you know, very quickly. And you know, when I heard the song for the first time, I bawled my eyes out because I lost my dad at a very young age and didn't really get to say goodbye to him. And so I wanted to dedicate the song to anybody who's lost somebody. I think they would very much understand the lyrics.
When
I've interviewed you before, and you've talked about your dad, you've always got a sense that he's sort of with you. You must have obviously been very sad he wasn't there to see your kids, but do you feel like he's still there?
No, you really set me off. Yeah, I do. Yeah. We both lost our dads, Andrew and I, and so we named Xander with our Xander Robert Selwyn after our fathers. So, you know, I believe that they're both looking after him. Hopefully.
Well, he'd be very proud of you, I think.
Oh, thank
you've had an amazing career, and you've got a tour coming up.
Yeah, I'm on tour in 2019 and got the new album, which is called Guiding Lights.